Hey everybody, I'm Braxton Lanciel, Senior Partner Engineer at Niantic. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to use Virtual Studio in Lightship ARDK. Virtual Studio is a tool we've created to help you develop your applications in Unity without the need of constantly having to run the project on a device to see how it behaves. Virtual Studio can mock scenes and run Lightship ARDK features in the Unity Editor Play mode with the same results as you'd find using a device camera. So join me as we go step by step. And remember that you have all the details provided in the transcription below this video. To begin, you should have a Unity project open and ready with the Lightship ARDK libraries imported. If you're not sure how to do this, please refer to our Getting Started with Lightship ARDK tutorial, and you'll be ready in no time. Additionally, if your scene is new, we need to delete the default camera from the inspector panel. Next, let's add an AR scene manager by searching on the project search bar, and then dragging that into our scene. The AR Scene Manager comes with an AR camera, which, in fact, replaces the camera we've just deleted. However, it also has all the settings ready for the AR experience both on your device and in Unity. Optionally, if your scene is new, you can simply add a Lightship template from the Lightship Hub by navigating to the Lightship menu, Lightship Hub, and selecting Welcome. From the Welcome window, you can select, for example, the Object Placement template. Remember that if you already have ARDK elements in your scene, you won't be able to load a new template. Now that our Unity project is all set, let's open Virtual Studio by navigating to the Lightship menu, ARDK, and selecting Virtual Studio. A new window will open with the Virtual Studio panel. Feel free to drag the Virtual Studio tab and place it where it suits you best in your Unity layout. To begin mocking our scene environment, let's click the Mock button in the Virtual Studio window. If we leave that at None, there will be no mock scene. In Virtual Studio's Mock tab, there is a Mock Scene drop-down menu where we can select the mock scene that we want to use. But first, we need to import those mock scenes. If you've already imported the Lightship Hub into your project, it already contains several mock scenes that will appear in this list. If you're unsure how to do this, you can refer to the Getting Started tutorial. You can also import mock scenes directly into your project. To do this, simply go to the lightship.dev, sign into your Lightship account, select the Downloads tab in your dashboard, and then find the ARDK Mock Environments package to download. Now back in Unity, let's navigate to the Assets menu, Import Package, then select Custom Package, and select the Mock Environments package that we've just downloaded and saved. A new pop-up window will appear, allowing us to select the components that we want to import. In this case, we want the whole package, so simply click Import to complete this process. In the Virtual Studio window, from the Mock Scene drop-down menu, we can select the virtual scene that we want to use. For example, let's try the exterior scene. Simply select it from the drop-down menu, then press Play in Unity. The Mock Scene will now be shown in the game view when we're in play mode, and hidden when we're not in play mode. Mock environments are not compiled into your project. They're only loaded during runtime inside the editor. Also remember that Virtual Studio is configured for the current session of the project. So if we close Unity, or if we close our project, then when reopening it, we'll need to select the mock environment once again. In Unity's play mode, with Virtual Studio mocking the environment, we can control the camera and move it around as if it were a camera in the real world. You can use the AWSD keys to move your camera around, and use your mouse to control the view, as if you're playing a first-person game. If needed, we can change the move and look speed using the respective sliders on the Virtual Studio window. Lastly, there is a checkbox available if we want to use our mouse scroll to look up and down in the natural direction, or to scroll in the opposite direction. Let's stop the play mode now by pressing the play button again. As we've previously seen with Lightship Hub installed, the Mock Scene drop-down menu contains different options, such as Exterior Scene, Interior Scene, and Mesh Interior Scene. Let's go through them by selecting each one and pressing Play to get a feel of what they look like during play mode. It's important to understand that the differences are not only visual. Each of the mock scenes were designed to work with different ARDK Lightship features. This way, you can test ARDK features of your project as if they were being tested with the feed of your camera in the real world. The interior scene is meant to simulate closed spaces. So this would be more appropriate in applications that are intended for indoor use. During play mode, you can test ARDK features such as plane tracking and image detection. Mesh interior scene looks similar to the interior scene, but with one big difference. Mesh Mock incorporates mesh colliders to the simulated environment, making it useful to test ARDK and Unity Collider features. Exterior Scene mocks an outdoor environment with the capability of running ARDK semantic segmentation and semantic masking features, while allowing the use of plane tracking as well. ARDK features such as these are the cornerstone of augmented reality applications built with Lightship. To learn more about what they do, visit the documentation on the lightship.dev website. Also, feel free to test the different features using the templates provided in the Lightship Hub. Navigate to the Lightship menu, Lightship Hub, and select Welcome, and then choose the template you want to check out. Remember, you can only have one template open in your scene, so if you already have ARDK elements in your scene, you may need to delete them before opening their template. Before we wrap up, remember that you can also create your own mock scene environments to use on your projects. You can find more info on how to do this by visiting the lightship.dev/learn page and review documentation in more detail. You'll find step-by-step guidance to create your own environment in no time. That's all for now. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll catch you in the next guide. Happy developing!